Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I will share all of the books that I read in 2022. I will briefly describe each book and share some of my favorite quotes from each book. If you want more book content, comment hashtag booktube. The first book that I read this year was The Worst Best Man. It has enemies to lovers, fake dating, Brazilian culture, yummy dishes, compelling main characters, great supporting characters, and it is a quick read. I finished it in less than 24 hours, so that tells you how much I love this book. If you want to see a description, pause the video. Not only did I include a description and some features from the book, I included some of my favorite quotes. So here is one of my favorite quotes from The Worst Best Man. The second book that I read this year is It's Not Supposed to Be This Way, Finding Unexpected Strength When Disappointments Leave You Shattered. It has Bible verses. It is a powerful read. The author is extremely vulnerable and she shares her own stories and testimonies. And it definitely encourages readers to seek God when they are in times of trouble, when disappointments arise, because he is our strength and he will keep us going. His presence is in the process and there's purpose in what we go through. So definitely read that book. The next book that I read was How to Fail at Flirting. I love this book. I love the supportive friendship. I love to see Naya's growth throughout the story. I loved Jake. He was so amazing, like literally the perfect book boyfriend ever. And it's a great story that tackles all different types of heavy issues. So definitely check it out. He felt like safety, like home, like more. The next book that I read was The Wedding Date. It is the first installment within a series written by Jasmine Guillory. It is a fast read. It has a black female main character. It tackles privilege, self-confidence. There is so many LOL moments and I love the ending. It was so good. So definitely check it out. When was the last time he laughed this much? He'd been laughing with her since that first moment in the elevator. The next book I read was While We Were Dating by Jasmine Guillory. The suitcase scene was hilarious. In this book, you'll get a cameo from some of your favorite characters. I won't say who, but you'll see. And I really like how it tackles Hollywood pressures, mental health, and the importance of therapy. Check it out. This is one of my favorite quotes from While We Were Dating. Next up, we have The Wedding Party. This is also in the Jasmine Guillory The Wedding Date series. Make sure you read The Wedding Date before you read The Wedding Party because you'll be more attached to the storyline and what happens, so definitely check it out. Also, the black Channing Tatum, so hilarious. Love that part. Maddie and Theo had a life outside of their relationship, but also they knew how to be vulnerable and show each other different parts that other people didn't know about them, so I really like that. Next up, we have Royal Holiday. So after you read The Wedding Party, you could read Royal Holiday because it shows us Maddie's mom. It's a more mature season love romance. It has holiday spirit. It has England. So I really enjoyed the setting. The characters were good. It was a quick, fun read. And I love Maddie and Vivian's relationship. Great mother-daughter relationship. Next up, we have The Fastest Way to Fall. This book is so amazing. As you see, I gave it 5 stars. I love this book. I would read it again and again. Excellent written main characters. I love the friendship and the connection that these two characters built. Wes, amazing. Amazing. I loved him. Brittle was a boss, definitely one of my favorite main characters. Next up, we have Get a Life, Chloe Brown. I love that this book tackles so many different issues, such as healing from an abusive relationship, living with chronic pain. This book really encourages readers to get out of your comfort zone and also to open up yourself to love again, to open up yourself to new friendships, so I really enjoyed it. Some moments were a little too much for me, so that's why I got a 3, but it was a good book. Next up, we have The Proposal. Really enjoyed this. This is also part of the Wedding Date series by Jasmine Guillory. This book carefully tackles life after losing a loved one, so I really like that. I also love the food. I love that these two built a friendship, and I really enjoyed their support systems. So yeah, I really like this book. I would read it again. Also, if you enjoy getting both characters' point of view, this is a good one because the transitions are so smooth. Really liked it. Next up, The Wedding Crasher. This book has great character development, good supporting characters, the food, again, so good, just like with The Worst Best Man, because they're both written by Mia Sosa. I really like the distinction between life goals versus career goals. There's opposite to track, fake dating. I really liked it. Also, I really like that they didn't want to hurt each other and they understood the importance of their friendship. Some books, they really like to go blow for blow, hit for hit, but that book, I liked it. It wasn't super dramatic at the end, you know, the 80% mark that all these romance books gotta hit you with some drama. Speaking of drama, this book had quite a lot of drama, especially towards the end. What I did like about it was the representation, dual point of view, the setting, Eve's growth. I really enjoyed Eve's character. Like, she's one of my favorite characters. I liked her a lot, and I like the laugh out loud moments. There were so many, especially the car scene. Like, I actually was cracking up at that. And the duck pond scene, that's a good one. You guys, this book had the potential to be 5 stars. Like, I never wanted a book to have 5 stars more than this one, but the side characters ruined it for me. Like, this is the first book that I've read where I did not like the side characters. So let's get into what I did like about this book. The Puerto Rican dishes, Camila Vega, I really, really liked her character. The Madeline grandfathers, at first I didn't really like them, but then they grew on me, and now I see the potential for there to be more books within this series, because the grandfather, he's going to continue meddling, he has to meddle in his other grandchildren's life. So I really like that. I like Liam's description of Camila. He's so attentive and he really vividly describes her. This book also tackles life after losing a loved one, and in both cases they both lost somebody that they really loved, so I really like that. And this book was very different from other books that I read. Let's get into my next book, Buy the Book. Have you ever wondered what your favorite fairy tale would be like in the modern world? This book gives us a modern take on Beauty and the Beast. I really liked it. Some of my favorite parts about this book were Beau's notebook, the setting, love the setting. I love the character development. I love the grumpy sunshine trope with the enemies to lovers mixed into it. And I liked how it was a book about books, and both characters loved books, so that was cool and different from other books that I've read. All right, let's get into another 5-star read. This book, The Happy Ever After Playlist, this book is the only book that made me cry. Like, I cried, and I don't know if it was because it was that time of the month, or like I genuinely should have cried in that scene, but listen to me right now. This book was so good. Like, Jason, absolutely incredible, the most perfect book boyfriend ever. I love the supporting side characters. Tucker, amazing. I love Tucker. I love the whole storyline of how he got to the car and how he was sent to bring them together. Like, I love this book. I could give a 30-minute presentation about why I love that book. Also, this book carefully tackles dealing with grief and life after losing a loved one. Such a good read. Next up, we have Fake It Till You Bake It. This book was really good. This was my first time reading a book about a football player who owns a cupcake shop. He bakes cupcakes. Like, yes, please. I really like Donovan's character, and I loved his friends. And there's definitely potential for this to be a series, because I want to read more about his friends, especially August. It's a quick read. There's enemies to lovers, fake dating, and I really liked the book club scene. That was so good. Next up, we have The Dating Playbook. We have another footballer in this book. So we have Jamar Dixon. He's injured and he wants to get back into the NFL. So he needs Taylor to come help him. There's forbidden romance. There's fake dating. It's a good book. Also, I love that it's more than just a romance. There's grief, anxieties, guilt, so many different issues being tackled within that book. I really liked it. Next up, we have The Last Black Unicorn. She ready. This book was very enjoyable. I loved reading in Tiffany Haddish's voice. Like, I could hear her as I read each line. This book can be really heavy at times, especially when she shares her past trauma, but she's just so strong and full of light. Like, I really liked how positive she was throughout the whole book. Although there are many heavy moments in the book, there are also lots of laugh out loud moments. Like, you'll actually laugh out loud at some of the things she talks about. But yeah, definitely check out that book if you want to learn more about Tiffany Haddish. Next up, we have The Gratitude Diaries. This book encourages readers to think more positively and have a grateful heart. I really like that it was a year-long experiment, and she took us through the entire year, and she focused on how being grateful affected different areas in her life, such as her career, her marriage, being a mother. I like that she included research, celebrities, other external sources to support the importance of being grateful and shifting your mindset. Next up, we have Not Like the Movies. I really went in with this book with high hopes because I felt like it was a great setup. It had so much potential, but it didn't meet my expectations. I really loved Nick, and I liked Chloe's dad. Those were the only two characters I liked. I did like that they emphasized the importance of letting people in and learning to accept help. And they referenced different rom-coms, but it wasn't as good as it could have been. Next up, we have The Unhoneymooners. This book was another book that had so much potential, but it didn't do it for me. Like, the first half of the book was amazing, and then the second half, it was like a completely different book. I'm just going to pretend that the second half of the book doesn't exist, and only the first happy Hawaii newlywed activity part exists, because those are the best parts of the whole book. I really like the activities that they did together. There's fake dating and fake marriage tropes, so you can give it a read, but don't have high expectations. All right, let's get into a book that I absolutely loved, a book that is my favorite book from 2022. I loved everything about this book, wouldn't change a thing. The writing, absolutely incredible, so vivid, so detailed, so descriptive. The characters, amazing. everything about this book, perfection. Black love, black excellence, black joy. I loved everything about it. The references to TV shows, movies, especially the R&B songs, like their playlists, literally me. This is the only book where I went on Spotify to listen to the playlist for the book. Like, who does that? Me. That's how much I loved all of the references. I loved everything about it. Like, listen to this. She's the perfect shot, and the perfect shot isn't about something being flawless. It's about the truth. She's the truth to me. Clarity. The world is doable when she's near me. Guys, I can't. That's not even the only line. I have to insert this other line. There's so many more, but check this out. I also know how my favorite movies make me feel. They pull me in and pull me out. I am totally in their world, but they also make me look in. I watch them and feel home. I watch them and feel like I can never know enough. I watch them over and over, always ready to discover the universe they create. That's how she makes me feel. There's a whole universe in her, and I will be so lucky to live in it, explore it over and over. So after I read Honey and Spice, that incredible work of art, I read Do You Take This Man? And I was very disappointed because I loved The Fastest Way to Fall and How to Fail at Flirting by Denise Williams. So I thought this one was going to be just as amazing, but I was extremely disappointed. There were quite a few moments that I liked, like the pedicure scene, the muddy scene, and the sunburn scene. Also, I really liked having a glimpse into the pressures of the wedding industry. That was cool. And the fact that RJ was a wedding officiant and a divorce attorney, that was very different. But yeah, let's get into what I read next. Next up, we have The Perfect Fine by Tia Williams. This book was the first book that I almost DNF'd because it started off really bad. I didn't like it, but then it actually gets a lot better, so I'm glad that I persevered. I really enjoyed Eric and Jenna's connection and their friendship. I love the fact that it was a starting over romance, like she was starting over personally and professionally. Last but certainly not least, we have Drunk on Love. I like that this was focused on a Black-owned, Black family winery. I like the setting. I like the supporting characters. There's definitely potential for this to be a series because I want to know more about Marco's brother, Elliot, and other characters that they mention in the story. There were a few things that I would have changed about the book, but overall it was a good read. Comment down below a book that you absolutely loved reading this year. Thank you so much for watching today's video. See you next time.